Let's start with the basics. Hold it with the holes on top. Use your second and third fingers to play. This finger will settle down by the knot here, so I can keep a firm grip between thumb and fourth finger and steady it as I play. As you read the tablature, it will be as if you are laying the ocarina right down on top of the music as it sits on the table. So the dots at the top of the circle will be played by your middle fingers. The dots on the left will be played with your left hand. The dots on the right will be played with your right hand. The black holes are closed. The white holes are open. Let's talk about intonation. Instruments evolved into more complexity so they'd have a wider range and a more precise intonation. The ocarina is a very primitive, very simple instrument. The intonation is going to come from your breath, from your tongue. Like a tennis racket, I find that there is a sweet spot in every ocarina. There's a certain air pressure that gets you the best tone for each note as you travel up and down the scale. When you first start, it may not seem exactly in tune, but as you practice with the music, you'll get used to finding that feel of the sweet spot. Let's try a few simple tricks. I find that this is a great place to start with the kids. Like a trombone, the ocarina can slide. I find this is great practice to leading in to being able to slide between notes as you play. There's also the flutter tone. The kids think that's fun. I'm just doing this with the end of my tongue. It's a lot like going like this, but with my tongue. And last but not least, you can tongue it just like you would a recorder or any other woodwind to keep your notes precise and nicely cut.